Hi everyone, my name is Jeremy Bell and I am the composer of Addison Red Line. I was asked to create a short video giving an explanation on the background of the piece, and I thought it was a great idea. So to start off, I need to cover just a little bit of baseball history. Baseball has been one of America's most popular sports for over 100 years. And in 2016, we finally got to see history in the making when one of the most loved teams in baseball finally made a dream for millions of its fans come true. The Chicago Cubs have never really been considered a strong team in baseball, but despite their shortcomings over the years, have always had one of the most dedicated and loyal fan bases of any sport. Nicknamed the Lovable Losers, the Cubs had a reputation for being a perpetual underdog. Failing to win the National League pennant since 1945 and unable to clinch a World Series title since 1908, the Cubs being down 3-1 in the World Series of 2016, finally made an incredible comeback to beat the Cleveland Indians in Game 7 of the World Series. The piece Addison Red Line is inspired by the spirit and energy of Wrigleyville, which is home to Wrigley Stadium, where the Chicago Cubs play, and is a mecca for baseball fans. The Addison Red Line stop is actually part of Chicago's public transportation and is a central hub for fans going to watch the game. It's not unusual to see thousands of fans donning their favorite athlete's jersey or other attire to show support for their team as they wait for the train to take them into Wrigleyville. Even those not going to the game come out to Wrigleyville to meet up with friends, usually for drinks or food at any one of the neighborhood's numerous bars or restaurants, where it's almost guaranteed that every single TV is going to be tuned to the Cubbies playing. I work at a place called Slugger's World Class Sports Bar, which I'm going to include a picture of real quick. And this is one of the nights of the World Series games where you can see the bar in the background and all the people who are just jam-packed. Those are actually streets where people just flooded into it and no traffic could actually get by. The excitement draws people in and creates an atmosphere of levity and joy, all centered around the fervor that baseball season brings to the neighborhood. The Addison Red Line tries to capture that feeling and energy, and just to give you an idea of how crazy the whole area is and the energy of it, I've included a video of the night that the Cubs won the World Series, and so everybody is standing in Wrigleyville looking up at the marquee for Wrigley Stadium as they finally get the news that the Cubs have finally beaten the Indians and clinched their World Series title. Their first World Series title in 108 years. I hope you guys enjoy the piece. So I'm going to show a couple of photos real quick of the parade that happened 2 days afterwards on that Friday, just to show all of the people that came out to Chicago. There were actually over 5 million people that came out, and it's set a record as one of the top seven, I believe, gatherings of people in one single area. And so after 108 years, they finally got to celebrate. And so I'm going to include those pictures and also the video. So I hope you guys enjoy the piece. Thank you so much for playing. Thank you.